fresh chapter of Turing Dev Talks, where we take a cursory glance of the basic concepts of skill sets and technologies that top American companies look for in software engineers. I am Alina, tuning in from Gurgaon, India, and today we have with us Peter, who's joining us all the way from Lagos, Nigeria. A coding ninja in the truest terms, Peter is skilled in languages like React, MySQL, Node.js, amongst others. His expertise in the shoes of a full-stack engineer has shaped Turing in the last 2.5 years. And today, we'll hear him talk about Node.js, its features, applications, and why you must learn Node.js to get amazing jobs with elite US companies in the Silicon Valley. Hi, Peter. Thank you so much for joining us today. How are you doing?
Hi, Elena. I'm doing fine. How about you?
I'm doing well, Peter. Thank you so much for asking. So 2.5 years at Turing, how does it feel? And how has your experience been this far?
So for the past 2.5 years at Turing, it has been an awesome time for me. It has been a time full of learning, full of improvements in my career and in my skills. And financially, it has been a good time for me because 8 months after joining Turing, I was able to buy my own dream house. And Turing really played a very huge part in making that happen.
Okay, that sounds amazing. And it's really good to see that you're having an amazing time at Turing. So would you like to tell us more about how Turing made this possible, how you were able to buy your own dream house?
So Turing make this possible in a way like when we talk about the salary in at Turing is far much better than any local company out there. So they have good salary structure. So this enabled me to save more and cut some of my expenses to save more to get my own dream house. So all thanks to Turing.
Okay, that's amazing. And I'm sure that you will stay with us for a very, very long time. Now, Peter, let's begin with a brief introduction of Node.js. How exactly is Node relevant in the current scenario? And if you were to give our audience a clearer picture of its applications, where is Node.js most frequently used?
So when we talk about Node.js, so I believe in our current century now, it's more relevant. So, and there has been a rise in demand of Node.js engineers in Silicon Valley and many more tech industries all over the world. So when we talk about the various applications of Node.js, we can talk about applications like real-time charts. We can use Node.js for that. We can use Node.js for Internet of Things. We can use Node.js for complex single-page applications like we have in React and Angular. Then we can use Node.js for real-time collaboration tools, streaming applications, microservices, architecture, and so on and so forth. So there are a lot of places where we use Node.js today.
Okay, sounds like almost every place and every day-to-day application makes use of Node.js in some form or the other.
Yeah.
In line with that, can you also give our audience a brief idea of how Node.js works? I think it would help them better understand its use and applications.
Okay, so when we talk about a web server using Node.js, it has a typical workflow that is quite similar to the diagram shown. So when the client sends requests to the web server to interact with the web application, this request can be blocking and it can be non-blocking. So, and the request can be in various forms. It can be a request to query for data. It can be a request to create data or to delete data or updating the data. So what Node.js does is that it retrieves this incoming request and add those requests to the event queue. So the requests are then passed one by one through the event loops. So the event loops check if the requests are simple enough and does not require external resources, like maybe database or some other stuff like that, or third-party API. Then the event loop begins to process this simple request in a kind of non-blocking operation, such as maybe input and output pooling. It then returns the response to the corresponding client. So a single thread from the pool is assigned to this single complex request. This thread is responsible for completing a particular blocking request by accessing external resources. And when we talk about this external resource, it can be a computational resource, it can be a database resource, it can be a file system, it can even be another API somewhere, so and so forth, so on and so forth. So once this task is carried out completely, the response is sent to the event loops, which now sends the response back to the client. So, and that is just a simple summary of how Node.js operation works.
Right, right. That sounds amazing. And I think that's quite a detailed idea of how Node.js works. Aspiring devs, Peter has explained in great detail how it works. And I think it is the best time for you to switch to Node.js from PHP or Python. Coming back to you, Peter, now that we have a basic idea of how Node works, would you say that Node.js is better than all other popularly used languages like Python or PHP?
So, yes. So, and I will say yes because of some certain reason. One of the reasons is because Node.js provides the kind of simplicity in development because of its non-blocking input and output and even event-based model results in short response time and concurrent processing. That is, it processes the operation step by step. Then unlike other frameworks where developers have to use thread management. Then another reason is because it runs on Chrome V8 engine, which is written in C++. And those that are used to C++, we know that it's a very high performance language with constant improvement. Then also we use JavaScript basically on front end. Most of the front end that we see out there is built with JavaScript. So development will be much faster when we have both JavaScript running on the back end and on the front end, which makes Node.js much better than other languages. Then lastly, I will talk about a lot of libraries out there. We have lots of libraries out there that make development so easy so that we don't need to start creating things and reinventing the wheel over and over again. So furthermore, what makes Node.js stand out from the rest of other backend development language is the different set of APIs. So Node.js APIs include streams like HTTP requests, child processes, and even support for file system, so which makes it possible to handle the same amount of load with less horsepower. Thank you.
Okay. That sounds like Node.js is definitely giving a tough competition to PHP and Python.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Peter, we both know that Node and PHP are major backend technologies that power web applications, right? And even though PHP is relatively old, recent trends suggest that Node.js has an upper edge and it's being used very, very frequently these days. So what are the major differences between the two, PHP and Node?
Okay, so if I'm to state the differences between PHP and Node, so the first thing that will come to mind is PHP is synchronous in nature. So though we have some APIs today that behave asynchronously apart from the synchronous load, but when we talk about Node.js, it's asynchronous in nature, which means it runs the JavaScript engine runs through the entire code in one go. So it doesn't have to wait for one function to return before calling the next function. So it calls the function at a go. Then another thing is that when you want to write code in PHP, you need to continuously switch between different languages and syntax. So, and that is because PHP, when we talk about PHP, it uses the part of LAMP stack, which include MySQL for database, PHP for server side. And you even need to learn Linux also to understand how to write code in PHP better. But in Node.js, it is purely written in JavaScript, which makes both the server side and the client side based on JavaScript. And there is no need to always switch between languages. So once you know JavaScript, you can easily develop with Node.js because you'll also be using the same language on the client. Then another one I would like to mention is that when we talk about some frameworks in PHP, we have frameworks that make backend development easy. Like we have Laravel, we have CodeIgniter, we have CachePHP. Then in Node.js, we have frameworks like Express, we have full stack frameworks like Meteor, we have Debian, and many new frameworks are even coming out, like QuadJS, like RPJS, like TotalSalesJS, and so on and so forth. So people are really supporting Node.js now because of a lot of frameworks that are coming out. Then when we talk about the database aspect, I believe PHP only collaborates with relational databases like MySQL, MariaDB, PostgreSQL, and a lot of other relational databases. But Node.js works perfectly with both relational and non-relational databases, that is, even databases with the NoSQL database, like MongoDB, CodeDB, and we can even work with GraphQL database system in like Node 4j. So these are some of the major differences between Node.js and PHP.
That's a great explanation, Peter, and that was quite an elaborate analysis of both Node and PHP. I'm sure this would give all aspiring devs a very good picture of the differences between the two and where both of these two languages are used. Now, Peter, that we are on the topic, we would also like you to share some use cases of Node.js and PHP. It would give our aspiring devs a good idea of the differences between the two and where all of these are used.
Okay, so when we talk about PHP, let me start with that. So it's used mostly in developing CPU-intensive applications like meteorology applications, scientific applications, and some other high CPU intensive application. Why, when we talk about Node.js, is ideal for developing high scalable server side solution because of its non-blocking IO operation and event-driven model. So, and when we want to talk about the few global websites that use PHP, we can talk about websites like Facebook, like Wikipedia, like Slack. We can talk about Mailchimp. We can talk about WordPress and so on and so forth. And when we talk about Node.js, we can talk about sites like Netflix. They use Node.js for their servers. Then we can talk about Walmart too, who chooses Node.js because of the asynchronous IO operation and the way how efficient Node.js handle concurrent requests. Then we can talk about big website like Uber, like NASA. We can talk about PayPal, who also trust Node.js enough to use Node.js for their application.
It's actually very impressive, the use of Node.js in applications like Netflix, Uber, and Walmart. But we clearly can see that both PHP and Node.js have different uses. On this note, Peter, do you think aspiring devs should begin their journey with Node.js rather than all the other languages?
Yes. So I believe they can. It's very good for aspiring devs to start their journey with Node.js. One of the reasons is because there is high demand for Node.js stack out there. So even in Silicon Valley and most of the tech industry, there is a high demand for Node.js developers. And I think the world trend is moving in favor of Node.js. And as a developer, I believe you want to move along with the trend. You don't want to stay outdated. So, and these are some of the reasons why I feel like we should, new developers, aspiring dev, should start their journey with Node.js so that they can keep themselves updated with the trend.
Okay, excellent. Aspiring devs, we have exciting opportunities for you here at Turing. If you believe to be confident in the skill sets that you possess, you can head on to Turing.com/jobs today and apply to elite US jobs in the Silicon Valley. Moving on, Peter, let us talk about the features of Node.js now. What are some interesting features that aspiring devs must know or must be aware of before they start their journey with Node.js?
So when we talk about the features of Node.js, one of the features that should first come to mind is because of the asynchronous and event-driven feature. So the first thing, when we talk about the event-driven feature, asynchronous feature, all APIs in Node.js library are asynchronous in nature. That is, they are non-blocking. So an operation does not have to finish or end before the next operation takes place. So it's asynchronous. The whole code runs at a go. So, and it gets, and the way the server works is that the server moves from one API to the next API without waiting for the response from another API. And when the server gets the response from previous API call, it sends the response to the client. So there is no waiting time. Then another thing is Node.js is very fast. So because it's built on Google Chrome V8 engine and the library, Node.js library is very fast in code execution because of this engine, which is built on C++. Then another one is because Node.js is single-threaded. So it's single-threaded, but it's also highly scalable. So it uses a single-thread model with event looping. So event mechanism help the server to respond in a non-blocking way and make the server highly scalable as opposed to some of these traditional servers like PHP and some other ones that we mentioned. We created a kind of limited thread to handle requests. So Node.js uses a single-thread program, and the same program provides service to a much larger number of requests than traditional servers like Apache and HTTP server. So, and another feature of Node.js is that there is no buffering. So Node.js never buffers any data. Node.js applications always output their data in chunks. That is, as the data arrives, it outputs them. So there is no buffering of data. Then one interesting feature about Node.js is the license. Node.js is released under MIT license.
Okay, that sounds awesome. Especially the MIT license and its feature of speed are interesting features to note here. Now, Peter, I think we've covered the basics of Node, and I think with this, we've come to an end of this discussion. But before we let you go, I'm sure our devs would love to know more about the important tips on resources and tutorials that they must look at before they start their journey with Node.
Okay, so if I'm to recommend resources for aspiring dev, I think we have a lot of them out there on the internet. We have a lot of YouTube video from Free Code Camp and some other websites that are beginner friendly. And at the same time, I will also recommend aspiring dev to learn how to use documentation, because in video tutorials or other articles that you may see out there, they may cover the basics, but if you depend only on tutorials, you always need to watch new tutorials to keep yourself updated. And you may not really have much time to watch tutorials. So documentation is also a good way to go, so that when there's any update, when you learn how to use documentation, you always keep yourself updated from time to time.
Okay, that was helpful. That was helpful. Thank you so much for being with us today, Peter. It was great. It was great having you on board with us. Again, thanks for being a part of a global community of extremely skilled developers and engineers. We hope that this video reaches the larger developer community and helps us give many more such opportunities to developers like yourself from across the globe. To everybody out there, if you have any questions, please feel free to drop us an email at support@turing.com. Let us know in the comments below who you would like to see on the panel in the next video. Give us a big fat thumbs up if you like this video, and do not forget to subscribe to Turing.com. We will be back with many more such Turing Developer Diaries and Turing Dev Talks. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and click on the link in the description below to apply to Turing.